Kamalam, Mpumelelo, Mfula. Streets know me as Frypan. And I'm a creative entrepreneur. So far as my personal life and how it influences what I do right now, it's lived experience of the black condition. And what that means is that black communities are the ones that face a lot of struggles and challenges. And having lived within those that experience, I have firsthand experience of them. And that gives me an added advantage in so far as solving them and making money off them. So I don't have to do research like all these big companies and put in millions and a lot of time. But of course, there is primary market research. I want to be remembered as a responsible contributor to the African development, or to the development of Africa, rather. Why? Because I know and realize that I'm a small part of in the bigger scheme of things, I'm a small part of the growth, but a very essential one. So it's not all about me, but it's all about what part I play in the growth and the discourse of African development. What inspires me? Reality, the African reality. It's a big inspiration because a lot of what I do and my approach to it is really based on how we have creatively responded to oppression. So the beautiful thing about that is that your people at Corner West would say that we are people of time and not space, because we haven't owned space for a very long time, so we really don't know much about how to interact with space. But with time, we do it very artistically, you know, from Western African, those ships that go in from West Africa to America. There's the slaves survived through songs just to keep mentally sane. In the fields, they communicated via a certain language through song. Mines, there was a certain language and it was communicated through song and kampu dance and all of that. So you get that. I've always had an artistic reaction, you know, and that's why in the arts we thrive so much, because our reaction has always been artistic, and that captures time and we interpret time. That's why we, you know, we're able to dress well, to adjust well to new genres and so forth. It's in our DNA now because of our modern history. So that really influences how I approach business and entrepreneurship. I don't try to take references from very far away. I just look at how we've always done it, make it plausible to the day and time and functionality. And there it is. That's what we're doing with Playground. We're actually taking a reality that we cannot access space, we cannot afford space. There is an artistic alternative to it. Don't ask for permission, because you're asking for permission from fallible people who may not want you to be better than them, and who don't know as much as you think they do, or who are not as capable as you. Never ask for permission, maybe sometimes, but avoid asking for permission, just do. You don't need to ask for permission from institutions, from friends, from parents, from society. Just contribute positively to society, because there is no institution, there is no person that holds the power of a godlike figure. So it makes no sense for you to actually ask for permission to do anything, especially if it's positive from anybody.